G'day folks, Rod from My Water Filter here today. And what we're going to have a quick look at is why you wouldn't want to use a reverse osmosis system on your rainwater, okay? Because it is possible, but we would not recommend that to you. And that's generally because of the usage of water that you're going to get from a reverse osmosis system. So what we've got in front of us here is two systems. Here's a good old mechanical filter, and here's the reverse osmosis system, okay? So rainwater, there's not too much wrong with rainwater normally, okay? Let's face it, it comes from the clouds, lands on the roof of your house, and from there, it's gonna fall into your water tank, all right? If you've got a concrete water tank, that water's gonna come into the house at about a 7 pH. If it's any other form of water tank, there'll be no interaction with the lime from the concrete, so the water will still be acidic as it fell from the sky, and it's gonna come into your house at around about the 6 pH mark is fairly close, okay? So rainwater coming into your home and there's not too much in it at all right? So normally we'd use a reverse osmosis system in the city or on bore water, or if you've got a water softener on your home or something like that, and you really need to get some nasties out of your water. Because they have the same filtration as the mechanical, so the rainwater would come in, it'll go through a sediment, take the lumps and bumps and leaves out, it'll go through a carbon, polish it up, take any herbicide, pesticide that could be in the water. Maybe it's good to take a bit of lead out or some copper from the copper pipe, all right? Then the water comes up and goes through this membrane. Well, that membrane's gonna split the water. So at that point, half of your rainwater is just going down the drain, and the other half is going to store into this tank. It'll hold in the tank till you're ready to use it. You hit the faucet, the bag in the tank pushes the water out the top. It'll flow through this alkalizer, which is basically a big cartridge at the back here full of mineral. That's going to elevate the pH up above 7, so we've got good quality alkaline drinking water from our rainwater. Carbon cartridge to polish it up. This would make magnificent water, don't get me wrong. But the wastage is high, all right? There's going to be a lot of rainwater wastage using a reverse osmosis system for your home, okay? And so this is what we would recommend for you, just a simple system, and you can have this in different forms, all right? So this water filter here would be if you were just pumping out of your water tank and into the home. You've got no pre-sediment filtration or anything, because if you had pre-sediment filtration before the house, you could drop this pre-filter off here and you could just go with the two major cartridges, all right? So today, the water's flowing into the home. We're taking all the sediment out here with this first cartridge, then it flows over and then it's going through the ultra pure. So this system here would have the cold stream cartridge inside of it, and that's gonna be taking all the bugs out of the water, all the bacteria, creates perfectly safe drinking water. No need for a UV, just a perfectly good ceramic cartridge like this and you'll be good to go. Remember at the start we mentioned if the water's retained in a concrete tank, it's gonna flow out at about a 7 pH, nice and neutral. The lime leaching out of the walls of the concrete tank will do that. But if you've got any other form of tank, you're gonna be having acidic water coming into your home and it'll be about a 6 pH. And if you've got copper pipe in your home water filtration, in your home water system, you may look in your basin in the bathroom and see some blue staining in there. And if you do see blue staining in the bathroom, good idea to give us a ring and have a chat to us about how to stop that before it eats all the pipe out in the whole home. But onto your filter here, sediment, ultra pure, bugs, bacteria, heavy metals, everything out here with this cartridge here, 100%. And then we run it through an alkalizer. This alkalizer is similar to the big alkalizer on the top of the RO. It's just a cartridge full of minerals. As the water goes through, it's food for the water and the water eats that mineral up and it dissolves into the water, elevates the pH. If you use an alkahydrate cartridge like here, it'll elevate the pH straight up to about 9. Over time, as the mineral dissolves over a year or so, that pH level will lower. When it gets down to 7, don't go below 7. We never want anybody drinking water below 7 because it's then acidic, not alkaline. So always try and consume water above 7. You can get a pH elevation cartridge, neutralizer cartridge to go in here if you just like to have 7 water and you don't want to go for the high alkaline, okay? So cheaper, easier water filter here. takes the nasties out of rainwater, which there can be at times. Don't think that there isn't, but this is a great way to go versus a reverse osmosis system for rainwater on your home. Have a look, let us know if we can help in any way. Thank you very much.